Alright, welcome to this Eeveesode number 17, where we're going to look at volume absorption and volume scatter for object shaders. So first of all, I just want to say to you all, I hope you had a nice weekend. I hope you watched the Blender conference either live at the place in Dubai, Amsterdam, or on live streams, which I did. I missed a couple of talks, which I later watched today on YouTube, but they were all interesting. Of course, I kind of wish we had more talks about Eevee, the Eevee renderer, and maybe also more like talks about the workbench and stuff like that. But anyway, let's jump into Blender and check out what's new for this version of 2.8. So I can already hear you say, "But Martin, you already showed volume scatter in episode 15. And all I can say to you is, be patient, young summer child. So this is the volume scatter effect on the world shader. So you can see it looks really good, and we have this like volumetric shadows, and but it's affecting the entire world. So if I turn this down, so we can actually see the background. We're going to check out the new feature, which has made this volume scatter and volume absorption shader possible on objects. So as you could probably guess, if we go into this object shader, we have a volume scatter shader. And if I mute the diffuse one, you can see it there. So yeah. Which gave me the reason to play this. So we got volume absorption and volume scatter enabled for object rendering objects or the object materials. So that's really cool. And if you have a blocky result, your sampling are probably too low. So if you have something like only 4 samples and maybe the tile size are really big, you get this like really blocky result. And so yeah, I'm gonna go with 32 for the overall sampling of the viewport, but then I'm gonna probably use 4 pixel tile size and 64 for volumetric, and I can leave the volumetric shadow at probably 32. Be a bit careful, because if you put the tile size to the very lowest 2 pixels and have a lot of samples, Blender can kind of freeze up meanwhile it's sampling the viewport, and so I'm gonna go with 4 pixel and 64. I think that's okay. Yep. So let me just show you this. I have just this like wave texture, which I plugged into the diffuse texture channel now, but if I mute that one and we plug it into the density, and this is just a multiplier node, so I can make it less dense. We can kind of scale this up so the light sources are inside of the volumetric scattered object. But as you can see, it looks really nice already. We can kind of be inside this one and see the effect it has on the lights, and this bandings comes from the wave texture. So and my computer doesn't seem to really like this, so maybe I should have a little bit less samples. But I saw someone tweeted out like they made a cloud from one of these textures on a volumetric object. And as you can see, the light has kind of nice effects on this. But if I select one of these lights, we have this checkboxes to enable like shadow and contact shadow. Maybe we should have one of these checkboxes for enabling and disabling volumetric scattering and volumetric absorption. Like if the light should be able to affect those. It may be a bit hacky and not like how it's going to be in cycles, but it could be nice to sometimes, like, I don't want the volumetric scattering for this lamp, I just want it to lighten up something. And since we have this checkbox for shadow, maybe it should be there. I don't know. I can see a couple other things to ways to use this one. Obviously, this is going to be how Eevee renders any smoke seam and stuff like that. But and also like the volumetric scattering effect for the world shader. But I could also easily see myself using it like this, just having a gradient texture. So if we plug this into the diffuse, so it's just a black and white gradient texture, but connected to the or affecting the density of volume scatter, we can have this like height map fog. If you're making a game level or something, and you want this kind of from the ground up height map fog, then we could probably use this, and it kind of looks amazing. So there's another thing I want to show you. If we make this cube really small again, and let's plug this one in with the density of 1, and I'm gonna increase the resolution once again. And if I delete these two lamps, so we only have like a white light source. So, and if we increase the density to like too much, and then we scatter the red color. Maybe I need to have a bit more denser. Yeah, now we can start to see the effect. So what's happening, like this pure white light is hitting this cube. Of course we have this HDR map, but this is the one that affects it. And you can see that when you scatter on the red channel, in some places the blue, it's gonna hue or tint to blue. And I don't know what's it the technical term for this is, but you can really see this effect happening in subsurface scattering. So I really hope that this code kind of could help out with the subsurface scattering shader. And but yeah, that's everything I wanted to show you for the volume scatter and volume absorption for object. And regarding the subsurface scatter, I can check the, we can look at the roadmap. So subsurface scattering is, it's up for the first or the second week of November. So it's not that super far away. And hopefully that thing I showed you where it kind of scatters the red channel and hues a bit to the blue, that hopefully that code could help out with the foundation for subsurface scattering. There's also two more features that I'm really looking forward to, which is parallax occlusion mapping, which will make one of my favorite add-ons, Decal Machine, which will probably make it work in 2.8 and Eevee renderer. Then we have pixel depth offset. That's also a feature I'm really looking forward to. I've seen some cool case uses where somebody used it in Unreal and made like a foliage and debris and stuff like that really blend into the ground shader. So it's kind of hard to explain. But it's about like having on the shader base, I think, having it like going to a alpha, and you can make the two shaders mix, I think. But so those two features I'm really looking forward. And this was everything for the Eeveesode number 17, volume scatter and volume absorption. I hope you have a nice day, happy blending, and until the next time. Goodbye.